This is the application for the TP-Link Kasa Smart Light Strip Multicolor. Here we can see I actually have it right up here at the top under lights. I do like that this is a new look and feel for the Kasa TP-Link application, kind of breaking things up where we can see my lights are here, my smart plugs are all there, and then a smart switch there. So they kind of break things up together, which I like. And then they actually have a favorite, so that's gonna be your most selected devices there. Right here we have our TP-Link light strip. You can see that it is off, it is part of my home network. And right there it even shows if it was on, it would indicate what is going on right there. So it would show you your brightness and so forth. Clicking into our TP-Link, here we can see this is big old button, turn it on, turn it off. There's a nice animation that happens, letting you know, hey, something has been turned on. Up here, this is what I'm gonna call, and I incorrectly kind of label this later on, since behind the scenes, I don't film these in order. This is not actually to segment your light strip. However, it is to have quick launch for color and brightness. So you can pre-program a bunch of different ones up there and simply tap on them instead of having to come through the color wheel, set your brightness and color. You can set a bunch of quick launches right from the top there. But we're gonna come back to our power. Here you can see it is letting me know color, and then it's on 74% brightness. If I were to come into my effects very quickly, and I'm gonna set an effect just so I can show you, right here it will tell you the effect name as well as the brightness of whatever you have going on. Right here we have our brightness. So if I select this, it is a sliding scale from 1 to 100%. So you could do anywhere in between that simply by dragging and dropping your indicator. Next we have our white. So this will allow you to, if you're just using a white, make it a cooler white versus a warmer white. And again, this is a sliding scale. You can kind of see there, it lets you know the Kelvin number right there. So if you want to dial that in exactly to what Kelvin you'd like, you can do that from right there. We're gonna come down here to the bottom first quickly before we get into the colors, because I know that's what you're really interested in, but we're gonna talk about some of the other things that we can do. Effects will be discussed when we talk about our colors, because there's kind of pre-programmed color manipulation that you can do through effects. You have the ability to schedule. So I can create a schedule where I can have this turn on or off at a specific day, and then I can select time. So if I'm doing a routine, let's say I want to have this turn on at 11 a.m., but I want to do that only on the indicated days that are green, I can do that and then select save. And now I have created a routine. And from here, I have a routine toggle where I can say, hey, I don't want to get rid of this routine. I just want to turn it on or off. And I could do that by simply selecting that toggle. If I click into the routine, I can come all the way down here and select delete. Now they call it scheduling, I call it routines, but it's the same idea. Just hit that plus sign and then you can add whatever you'd like. And we're going to select back. And that's gonna bring us to our main screen here, again, because we left off on our white balance. Next we have usage. The usage I really like, because you don't get this with a lot of smart LED strips, but it will show you your energy usage for today. So here you can see, I haven't had this on for all that much today before filming. However, over the last 7 days, it shows me my energy usage in kilowatts and then the total time that it was on. And then if we come over here, here's a 30-day total energy usage and then total time on over the past 30 days. Here you can see some extra information right here, which is our savings per year. You can see I kind of don't keep this on all that often. It stays on for a couple hours as part of my Christmas lights, but that is our usage section. Like I said, effects and colors, we will actually cut out to a better view of the actual color usage and some of the things that you can do, as well as these up here, the pre-programmed smart areas, which I will call segments later on. Here we have our color segment wheel. And then from here, you could see I can just kind of drag this around. I don't just have to tap, but I can drag and the color will change. Notice that it kind of dynamically changes once I get to a spot, but these little in-between colors, not quite as much as the larger color changes, but that's kind of nice that it lets you do that. One of the cool things with this though, however, is the effects wheel. Now notice, we have our effects up here in place already, but if we ever wanted to change one of these, we simply highlight it, hit that button just like we did on the other page, and select delete, and that will allow us to remove it. Coming into color painting, this will allow us to manipulate the bulbs. Notice we have colors there. If I start touching these, I want this off. I want this off. Notice it's starting to shut down bulbs in the background there. Or I could say turn on, and I want it that color, that color, that color. I want that one to be that color. I want that one to be that color. Here I want blues over here. And notice we can change the color this way. And then we can hit save, and that'll save it as a color painting. I'm going to select don't save because, well, I don't want to save it. We also have the ability to customize effects. Here's a bunch of effects. Let me show you what those look like before we start customizing them. Coming down, we've got our aqua right here. So we'll give that a second to load up. And then you could see aqua kind of has this nice color shifting from greens to blues. We're going to bring our smartphone back into focus. Might be a little hard to see, but this is bubbling cauldron. We're going to give that a second to load up. Might be a little different. Difficult to notice subtle changes. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to come in and make the brightness 100% so that while we're messing with the effects, you'll get an idea of how they look, minus the fact that there's Christmas stuff in the background there. Moving on, we have candy cane, selecting that. You'll notice that it's going to shift from white to red. This is a very good Christmas color. A little tricky to see because you could see the bursts of red are a little shorter, so they're not getting picked up as well on the camera, but I do assure you they're there and they do look rather nice. Moving along with our effects, we have Christmas. This is the one that I generally keep up because, well, it's red and green. It's a little more noticeable than the candy cane and a little more subdued, but you do see that you have a little splash of green in there, ever so slightly. Moving on, we have flicker. So this is supposed to mimic a flickering candle. Again, this is another one that's a little subtler, so the camera might not be able to pick it up as well. Moving on, again, might be hard to see the screen, but Grandma's Christmas. So this is another Christmas style one. We'll let that load up. And there you see, it's slowly moving along. But there is a light. And there's the other one. So what this is going to do is kind of mimic the old colored light bulbs, like the really fat ones that burn through so much electricity. And you could see that kind of based on how they look up there on my wall. So you've got an orange one, a blue one, here's a white one, and it's representing that large bulb that you would have seen. Now we're gonna let that do one more, and then we're gonna come along to the next effect. As you see it moving across the chain there, and there we go, there's our green. Gonna bring this back into focus because the next one we're gonna do is Hanukkah, and here we go. That is a representation of Hanukkah. I'm assuming it's the menorah, but I'm not familiar enough to kind of get an idea of why that is colored the way it is. Next we have Haunted Mansion. Gonna bring that into focus, select Haunted Mansion, and there you go. Haunted Mansion kind of has like this lightning effect. So you see it's spooky lightning, you have this kind of hidden away, and it kind of adds some ambiance. You get some thunder going in there, it'd be even better. Next we're going to come up to icicles, which might be a little hard to see with the flashing in the background, but there you go. Here's your icicles. It's a very light blue, kind of shimmering a little bit. You saw that hopefully a little bit on the tips over there, but it's kind of pushing through. There you go, you can see some color waving through it. Next we have lightning. So that's a little different than the Haunted Mansion because this one doesn't do it as often. So I can actually sit here and talk for quite some time before this actually goes off. And this is one of the things with this particular one that kind of annoys me is I wish it did it a little more frequently. However, in the editing function, we can change that a bit. So we'll talk one more time, see if I can get one more lightning effect in here before I move on to the next one. But that's the thing with lightning, it is very random, so you might not notice it. All right, doesn't look like we're getting another lightning effect. So we're gonna bring this back up into focus and do ocean. So here you go, ocean effect. Switches a little bit between some teals and some lighter colors, kind of wafting ocean. Coming back up into focus, we have our rainbow effect. So here you go, it's gonna throw a single color across, but do this in rapid succession so that you get this rainbowed effect. Coming back up, we're going to do raindrop. And there we have what raindrops look like, kind of just scattered little lights, kind of blues and whites, just dripping around. It's a pretty cool thing without having to worry about strobing effects. Next we have right here, we have spring. And then spring, here we go. It's a green kind of pulsating through an orange and red, letting you see those spring-like colors. Again, Christmas motif up there, but 'tis the season when I'm doing this and generally when I have an LED light strip thrown across the back here. And then last but not least, we have right here, Valentine's. So selecting this, as you might imagine, is a very red background. Notice though that they are throwing some whites in there to kind of give more of a purpley effect. So instead of being a harsh blood red, you're getting more of a reddish pink for that particular effect. Now I'm going to leave that effect on and then we're gonna come back up to our, if I can get that to focus, customize effects. Here we're going to select our lightning and then do next. So right here you can see, here is the color palette that this particular lightning is doing. And there we saw a lightning strike in the background. So this is the color palette that it uses. We can select the random color right there and select save, or I can hit next and we can change the name. And there we go, it's doing lightning effect more often because I'm messing with this. There we go. Finally get to see those effects. Probably should have set a strobe warning, but we can change the colors and I can hit save after giving it a different name so that the lightning effect could have more purples in it and things of that nature. And we're just gonna hit X, which will bring us back to the Valentine's one, which is the one we last left off on. So that is all of the color manipulation that we can do for the TP-Link LED strip here. Coming back into the application, that's everything that you can do to control the LED light strip. But if we come up here to the sprocket icon, if I select this, this is actually going to bring us into the settings for the device itself. So right here, first up, first and foremost, we have TP-Link light strip. That is actually the naming convention. You can come in here, give it a new name. We can even come in here and select a different image if we wanted to. We can also upload an image from our camera's album or take a picture right now and have that as the icon, letting us know exactly what that light strip is or where that light strip is placed. Default statuses, these are really good. So on from app, it will resort last on state. Now we can change that if we want to, but we do need to have presets, which we did talk about before when we were talking about the colored areas. And then light strip will go to selected state when turned on from the app, on from power source, which is touching the button, and here it will come to the on state. Coming down, we have featured tutorials, device info, and then placement guide, and that's all that you really have under here. So you can control how it functions from the app and then how it functions from the button push. And then we come back and that's really all that we can do for the light strip via the settings portion of the application. Now, if we come back, I did mention that TP-Link has recently revamped and redone their application to make things kind of nicer. Here you can see there is a routine section right up there. You also have cameras now as a separate section. I don't have any cameras. You have smart. So this is again smart actions. So this is a scene that I created. You can have actions, which in this case I have one set up where if I toggle my smart switch, you can check that out in the corner there, it will turn on a smart plug that's over a workbench. And then featured animation. So if you didn't want to make your own, you can select a scene right from here. Activity, this is going to show you everything that kind of happens. Right now you can see not much has happened with my activity. And then you've got an account setting right there. That little red dot there means that there is something that needs to happen. Chances are it's a firmware update for something, so you always wanna make sure that you go in there and check that out. And that has been everything that can be done with the TP-Link Kasa Smart LED Light Strip.